Please pause for the moment of silence. Please stand for the pledges. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now for the Texas Pledge. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.
A little girl prevents a tragedy.
And a change that many people are noticing on a large social media platform.
As well as your weekly TikTok. All this and more coming up on NHSTV Live. A 12-year-old girl, Melania Andre, was riding home from Target. But what was expected to be a peaceful drive home turned dangerous, almost, when her mother started to seize while driving. The 12-year-old quickly noticed something was wrong when her mother was not responding. Not knowing how to drive at all, she got the car to a complete stop and prevented a tragedy.
Moving on to school news, last week NISD held a groundbreaking ceremony for the new Northwest ISD Aquatic Center that is expected to be opened in late 2020 or early 2021. We are so excited to see this be completed. Now, as everyone knows, it's homecoming week. What is our weather looking like, Ryan?
Well, Kaylee, I'm happy to say that we have a pretty clear week ahead of us with some lovely fall temperatures. Currently, we are in the mid-70s. It'll be a partly cloudy day with a slight chance of rain in the later evening of our hours. Not too much to worry about, though. Moving on to the weekly forecast, your homecoming parade will be mostly sunny with some pretty mild temperatures. We'll keep the trend of these fall temperatures in the 70s and 80s as the week goes on. There's no chance of any rain, so make sure you come out and support all of these homecoming festivities. Here's your extended forecast. And I'll be back in studio on Friday to give you an update for your homecoming weekend. Back to you, Anchor.
Thanks, Ryan. Now with homecoming week finally here, I know all of us are super excited.
I know I am. Kaylee, did you dress up for today's theme?
I did. And did you age over the weekend?
No, I left my wrinkles at home.
And if you forgot, tomorrow's dress up day is Decades Day, so make sure to dress up as your favorite decade.
And Thursday is TikTok on the clock, right? What does that mean?
It means you dress up as a meme or as your favorite TikTok or just as a clock. And then, of course, on Friday is Red Out, and I cannot wait to see all of y'all's mums and garters.
Also, the homecoming parade is tomorrow starting at 6. There's going to be great performances by our all-star cheerleaders and sidekicks.
And I don't know about you, but I love watching the fireworks, so I'm definitely looking forward to that.
It sounds like it's going to be a very busy and exciting week for us Texans. Speaking of homecoming, yesterday many different groups of students came in to decorate the hallways for homecoming week. NHSTV reporter Clarissa Rodriguez is in one of our newly decorated hallways. Clarissa?
Hey guys, I am here in the 600 hallway. So this hallway was decorated in like an under the sea type theme. The Spanish Honor Society decorated this hallway. There's a sign that says fish are friends, but parrots are not, because we will be going against the parrots for homecoming. There's a lot of great hallways out there, but this by far has to be one of the most creative. Back to you, anchors.
Thanks, Clarissa. Moving on, it's now time for this week's edition of Tech Talk.
Tech
Decades ago, the Federal Emergency Alert Program was designed to interrupt your TV show or radio station about severe weather or acts of war. Today, there is many different ways to watch TV that go through the internet instead, such as Netflix and Hulu. The research done on putting emergency alerts through these platforms shows there is no technological hurdle, and it would be quite easy to do. The only unknown is who would develop it and download this application. Also, for security reasons, making sure what is installed is completely secure and no one is able to hack into it. Moving on, dark mode is the it thing right now, becoming very popular on phones as well as social media platforms. Instagram just recently installed the dark mode feature on its app. This feature is very popular due to the fact that the appearance is very easy on the eyes and prolongs battery life. And speaking of dark mode, Fortnite leaves players staring at a black hole for hours before the release of Season 11. Even 4 hours after the game had gone down, about 50,000 people were still actively watching the game's live stream on YouTube and another 100,000 on Twitch. These players speculated that this was the end of Fortnite. Luckily, this morning, Fortnite Chapter 2 was released into a new world. That's all I have for you guys on this week's edition of Tech Talk.
In some sports news, on Friday, the Lady Texans went out to Denton High School to take on the Broncos. And while they fought hard, it would not be enough, as the Broncos would win all three sets over our Lady Texans. Don't worry, though, their next game is tonight in Denton Ryan at 6:30. This is a redemption game, so make sure to come out and watch the show. Moving from the court to the field, don't forget this week is homecoming week. Our football team will be taking on the Polytechnic Paris at 7 o'clock on Friday, and I can't wait to see you all there. Into professional news, the Cardinals played the Nationals in Game 3 of the Championship League Series. The first run of the game wouldn't be scored until right fielder Adam Eaton hit this base hit into right center field in the bottom of the third. Then, Rendon hit this rip down the baseline that was ultimately fumbled and dropped by the Cardinals, allowing yet another run. Then, Juan Solo struck the ball all the way up to right center field for this double run play. The Nationals continued the game like this and limited the Cardinals to only one run by Martinez, in where it appears that the Nationals missed the ball three times. In the end of the game, the Nationals would win 8-1. Washington is now only one win away from securing their spot in the World Series. I'll be back here on Friday to tell you who else is getting closer to the World Series.
Thanks, Shelby. Speaking of sports, our wrestling team recently got challenged by our little sisters, Eaton High School, to do a TikTok. Here's this week's edition of TikTok Tuesday. Everybody is on. Texans, don't forget we have PSATs tomorrow for freshmen through juniors. And seniors will be reporting to the pack with your Chromebook for senior blitz. So that means there will be no NHSTV tomorrow.
But don't worry, we'll be back on Thursday with another segment of Jackson Interaction and much more. This has been NHSTV Live.